Hi everyone, I'm Mike Casswell, and today we're going to be looking at some effects pedals. When I say effects pedals, I want to clear up kind of the differences. I want to let you know the differences between overdrive, distortion, and compression. So I've dug out some of my favorite pedals and some of my not so favorite pedals, and I'm going to run you through the pros and cons of each one. So in order to do this, I've set up two generic sounds on this Hughes & Kettner combo here. Fantastic amp. I've set up a nice kind of touch-sensitive clean sound. It's a generic kind of clean sound, because I'm sure most of your amps have got a clean side of it and a dirty side of it. And I've got on the other channel, I've got a crunch sound set up. It's a kind of a crunch sound that if I just back the guitar down slightly, it'll clean up quite nicely. And as I turn the guitar up, it'll kind of get more and more. So they're two kind of generic amp sounds. We all kind of need a clean sound and a sort of a crunchy, dirty sound. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to kind of explain to you how maybe the different effects pedals and different styles of effects you've got can affect your sound and enhance your sound, if anything. Don't forget, pedals don't replace your sound, they just enhance your sound. That's always the kind of the mentality to have. So I'm gonna start with a compression pedal. And now I've got one favorite compression pedal that is, for me, the best one that's ever been out there, really. And it's this blue CS-2 Boss compressor. They don't make it anymore. It was stopped being made, mid-90s, early 90s maybe. So they're quite hard to come by, but I think the replacement for it, the CS3, isn't quite as good. They kind of put a tone knob on it, and it just doesn't kind of respond in the same way. But what I'm going to do, I'm just going to show you what a compressor pedal does, and I'm going to go to my clean sound. So we've got this kind of vibe going on. So that's the amp kind of as it is, just plugged in. But the thing that the compressor does is it's almost like it boosts the output of your pickups into the amp, and it smooths out all those kind of harsh pick strokes that you might have. So if I just switch it on and just hit one chord, hopefully you can. Immediately, it's grabbing the chord and wanting it to sort of sing out. If I switch to my treble pickup and kind of hit some, let's see. You see, by tapping that octave, it's a little harmonic is jumping out, that's what the compressor is doing. It's taking the slightest little squick and squack of the guitar and making it leap out. Unless you've ever played through one, to know, it's a very hard thing to explain, but unless you've ever played through one, it's a kind of a feeling when you're playing rather than an actual sound thing. I know that sounds, you know, a bit ooh, out there, man, but it is a kind of a real feel thing. So it kind of smooths out all the imperfections and just makes it the guitar a nicer. It just makes a nicer feeling when you're playing. But if you take the compressor and switch it on when you're using a crunchy amp or a sort of a crunchy sound, if I go to my crunchy sound, bearing in mind how touch sensitive this crunchy sound is, I can kind of clean it up if I just turn down the guitar a bit. It's kind of clean. It's kind of clean at the same time, but as I turn it up. So what the compressor can do is it can kick more input into the front of the amp. So now it'll turn your crunching amp into a bit more of a sort of a gainy beast, as it were. Let me show you what I mean. So if I play some stuff in around here, that's the amp. If I play exactly the same thing with the compressor on, so it's now, you've almost turned your little two-channel amp into a three-channel amp by the use of a compressor. It is greatly affected by what guitar you use. If you've got an output, if your guitar kicks out a lot of output with a humbucker, then you need to back the compression off. But if you use like an old Strat or just a normal single coil Strat that's got quite low output, then you can push the compression on and it'll give more output to the pickups, but still retaining the tone of the guitar, which is really cool, which is why I use a compressor, you know, quite a lot in most situations. So hopefully that's kind of given you an insight into the compression side of things. Moving along,